We've got a special treat for you. Some travelers, come on up here, have just returned from that land of three coins and a fountain. That's right, here they are. You were clean-cut, preppy kids when you left. What happened?
Well, went in Rome.
Folks, I've never seen a change yet. You could take this mic, I guess. And you guys could share that.
Custodes, we've brought a few things to show you from our wonderful trip.
Wonderful, wonderful. Can you tell us a little bit about your trip as you...
It was molto bene. Molto bene.
Molto bene?
Molto bene.
What does that mean?
Divertito.
Divertito.
Divertita.
Very beautiful. Very
divertita.
Bellissimo.
What happened? Well, let's start with day one. You got off the plane.
Well, let's start with Rome. We'll start with Rome.
And you know what they say, when in Rome.
Can we get a close-up of this?
Oh.
Here we have a beautiful scene in front of the Colosseum with Romulus and Remus suckling. There we go. It was lovely.
Put Kenny on that title, too. We don't want to leave him out.
Here, there were many lovely gift items.
I got that
items.
One, too.
This is a thermometer with Romulus and Remus and the Pope.
The Pope? He's not Italian.
Papa. They all love Papa. We had a wonderful trip to the Vatican, and they wouldn't let me in the second day because of my miniskirt. So girls, cover up.
Kenny, what have you got to show
well,
us there?
How about this in Rome? The Wilma, a coat hanger, and a Pebbles, and they call her Petula. Isn't that
Petula?
Petula. Petula. Petula.
It's great.
Also for the walls, we both had got this.
You know what they say about Italian style? It's true, every word of it.
This is a three-dimensional pictograph of the crucifixion. Beautiful. You can get them in 14th Street, but only this one says Souvenir Roma. Souvenir Roma.
And if you turn it from side to side, I think they can get the 3D effect.
There we go.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh.
If our studio audience, our cosmopolitan studio audience is reacting this way, I can imagine what the viewer back home is doing.
And I got this in Pompeii.
Oh.
Yeah.
And I've got wonderful reading material now. Great literature from Italy. This one is Zora la Vampira. Can we get a close-up of the cover? It's beautiful. There. And we have some lovely scenes. Very, very good. Here is Zora biting. Italy is a wonderful country of great art.
And I got this, too. This nice Italian magazine, comic book.
Kai, I understand that when these people were souvenir hunting, you snuck off by yourself. Tell us what you did.
I went... when? In Rome?
Yeah, when in Rome.
I went back to my room one evening and found it locked. I heard strange noises coming from the inside of the room, and I was asked to depart to go take a walk.
Uh-huh.
Well, I went to...
Microphone.
Hold your mic up there.
Okay, I went out for a walk in order to find a light in my cigarette.
Uh-huh.
I stood there on the corner, it was a full moon, when a head, when the two... headlights of a car rolled up and just flashed right in my eyes like a Fellini movie. This car with the top down came down and it was filled with these four young boys. I leaned over and a hand extended and they lit my cigarette. I could look into their eyes and I could see that their pupils were dilated. I could see that they were on acid, so I decided to have a little bit of fun. I was dressed in my Italian suit. As a matter of fact, I was dressed exactly as I'm dressed right now.
Let's get a shot of the beautiful Italian suit. And so in brief, what was the upshot of the evening? Because
anyway, briefly, we just went for a drive from coast to coast.
Divertita.
It was a lot of fun.
I understand you folks brought back some videotape.
Oh, yes. Oh, I forgot.
And you're going to narrate a little travelogue for us.
Could we
roll that tape?
Sure.
There's some friends we met.
Yeah, we met some people in Venice, some other fellow Americans.
You should be able to see it on the monitors here.
Yeah, I don't see a thing.
Not yet.
Not yet. Oh, here we go.
Oh, there it is.
There are the hippies. We saw them in Venice.
There's Jess and Sunshine. They're real neat.
They were selling this tinsel there. They were selling the tinsel. Oh, there's a beautiful shot of Venice, the
canals. Oh, that was nice.
Oh, we like that. Any more? This is a lovely.
This is beautiful.
Now this is the water. This is the Venetian Canal. There we have.
All right, there.
That was nice. Yeah. There we go. Mm-hmm.
Remember, mm-hmm. I just threw my watch into the.
I was doing the camera work.
Oh, look.
Oh, there we go. The gondolas. I remember them. Beautiful.
Looks so romantic.
It was incredibly. And our friends, they shared their wine.
Sunshine Jess, yeah.
It was very expensive.
Hey, how you doing?
Hi.
Hey, how you doing? Hey, come here.
The last James
Great.
Taylor
Great, good to know you. Hey, how's it going? Great, I love Venice. It's beautiful here. Hey, it's great. Oh, it's my bro.
Let's see the bro handshake.
That's when they met, the two, Kai and Jess.
He's asking for it.
In Venice.
Yeah, I was doing the camera work on that.
God,
really
it was great.
Exciting.
It was great.
Yeah, he loves it there. Jess was really like...
He was very helpful, yeah.
Yeah, it was beautiful.
Venice is incredible.
Mm-hmm.
Just full of beauty.
Intenseness.
Very lush.
Yeah.
Some people have a great attitude.
We had a wonderful time.
We loved it. We'll go back.
Yeah, there we go. Oh.
It just brings to mind the Venice of
Could
old
we
with the fights between the feuding clans, the Medicis and the other ones. You can see it all right there.
Uh-huh.
It's incredible. And now they're World Cup soccer champions, too.
Yeah.
It was great. Oh, just watching it makes... I yearn for it.
Makes you want to get out and buy that plane ticket.
Yeah. Well, of course, our whole trip was financed by the Communist Party of Bologna. No, we would like to... That's a main facet of Italy. We'd like to thank the communists for making it all possible.
Thank you, Communist Party! Thank you, folks, and I hope you can come back again. Where are you off to next?
Well, Los Angeles.
Los Angeles, California.
Yeah, hit the LA scene.
Yeah.
Be great.
For sure.
I hope you take some videotape there.
Sure will.
Don't let yourself get too grody. That's what they say over there. They say everything's grody.
Awesome.
Well,
sure.
Wonderful to be here on the program of programs.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Kai.
Ooh, I heard that.
Mr. Kenny Sharp is a man known to millions of New Yorkers as being the principal exponent of Jetsonism. And I think he's coming. There he is. Mr. Kenny Sharp, ladies and gentlemen. Nice to have you here, Kenny.
Nice to be here. It really is.
Have a seat. Let me put this crap away. Well, it's really good to see you again.
Good to be here. Really is.
I know our viewers are like really anxious. They're all writing in. They want to hear about Jetsonism. What is Jetsonism?
Well, Jetsonism is a part of the whole religion of Hanna-Barberism. And the Jetsonism section is the Nirvana part, the really fun heaven part where you get to go.
Uh-huh. And that entails, I understand, I read your thing and it's something about the nuclear holocaust about to consume us all.
Well, it's on our minds, definitely, you know.
Uh-huh.
definitely on the minds of everyone. And
now, how does Judsonism relate to that, the impending Holocaust?
Well, it doesn't have to do with the Holocaust itself, but after the Holocaust, for everyone interested in fun, there's always Judsonism afterwards.
But you're one of the few people who've really given us something specific to do when the bombs are dropping on top of us, right?
Yeah, I can show you.
Yeah, it'd be great. It'd be great.
Well, when the bomb's coming and you know it's coming and you're really good,
yeah,
you like get up here and you like put your arms up like this, and like go through.
You go right up through the mushroom. You go right up through the.
Yeah, and there's a spiral on top. And that brings you right through.
So in other words, you go up through and you like spiral around and
it just brings you through the center. On the other side, you're in the land of
You're on the other side.
Yeah, that's great.
That's, you know, the reason that appeals to me is because everyone else is trying to scare us. You're saying, don't worry about it, just go with it.
If you're a good guy or a good girl, there's nothing to worry about. Just be good.
But that's if you're good.
Well, if you're not, then, you know, may not be so good, but...
Well, I'll be good.
Okay. I believe you're good.
Now, I understand you're all equipped to show us some of your icons, religious Judsonism icons.
Yes, I think I'm going to do some portraits tonight of my friends, Hanna-Barbera friends.
Great. Let's have a big hand for Kenny Sharp. He's going to go over and do some, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Yeah, I did have some music for you. I don't know where the tape went. It was good music. It's under here. Ah, here it is. Here it is. No props, no props. All right. His boy, Elroy. Oh, I see. You know, Elroy's got to be pretty old by now.
Well, he's about my age.
He kind of looks like you, too.
Yeah, I'm gonna do